Hey everyone, I'm Anna Dolosky. A recent report from the CDC sheds light on a very disturbing trend. About half of U.S. millennials are not getting tested for HIV. The study showed that between 2010 and 2014, the rates of HIV diagnosis decreased among those aged 16 to 19 years old, were stable among those aged 20 to 23, and increased among those aged 24 to 29, otherwise known as the millennials. About 40% of millennial-aged women and more than half of millennial-aged men surveyed reported that they've never been tested for HIV. Those numbers decreased even more when the age range was narrowed between 15 and 24 years old. The most common belief, that exposure to the virus is unlikely. Well, HIV was a sure killer in the 80s and 90s, that is until 1996, when AIDS cocktails finally appeared on the market. After that, annual deaths from HIV and AIDS for the first time decreased in the US. Over the last two decades, medicines for HIV have become more effective, and rather than taking upwards of 30 pills per day, the number has been reduced to one or two. By 2011, it became evident that drugs like Truvada, a two-drug combination pill, could not only restore the immune function of people with HIV, it also reduced the virus level in the blood, so much so that at times they can't even be measured. This is a clear win for science, and one that scientists and we here at the Council often celebrate. We've written on this topic numerous times, and yet, what's a win for science may not resonate with the rest of the community, especially not with millennials. Those who've grown up with a culture that treating HIV is simply a matter of fact, taking a few pills to manage the virus. After all, the CDC estimates that 1.1 million people in the US are living with HIV. About 166,000 of those are unaware of their status. While HIV and AIDS isn't the death sentence it was in the 90s, it's far from eradicated, and a vaccine is not in the near future. HIV and AIDS and its advancements isn't the only thing millennials are taking for granted. In Humboldt County, California, for example, rates of syphilis have spiked in recent years. In Texas, rates of syphilis and gonorrhea have been increasing since 2015. Nationally, rates of chlamydia and gonorrhea are on the rise. So what is the solution? More PSAs? More funding for education? Perhaps getting tested is the first best approach, and that's one science advancement we cannot take for granted. To see more stories like this, like us on Facebook, visit our website, acsh.org. Don't forget, while you're there, you can also sign up for your latest dose of news delivered straight to your inbox. For the Council, I'm Anna Dolosky.